Ankit has quoted a few lines. First one, either course taken would be taken under compulsion. These are the thoughts going through Dominique's mind and her conversation with Alvah after returning to New York. Next one, she wondered whether they whipped convict nowadays. Next one, she kept herself clean and free in a single passion to touch nothing. Next, she had liked the impotence of their hatred. Next, she was not free any longer. So, Ankit says, the way Dominique is struggling when her tendencies are coming to the surface, and how even after choosing the toughest choice out of all the ones available, she still feels defeated by Rourke reminds me of my life. Even I envy and get angry with people who bring my suffering to the surface and I try to take revenge on them. So he has sent over two questions. Pranamacharyaji, these two questions trouble me. Every tendency I have is just a chemical reaction. Then how is my restlessness not a chemical reaction? If it is, then why do I get affected to a situation if I know it's just a chemical reaction? The tendencies don't suffer. Ankit, you do. You are not your tendencies. Had you been your tendencies, why would there have been any suffering? So tendencies proceed as per preset patterns of chemical reactions. That's what tendencies do. And when tendencies do that, tendencies are all right. You are not all right when you act per your tendencies. When you say, how do I know that my restlessness is also not a chemical reaction? Your restlessness is because of the chemical reaction. Your restlessness is because of your association with the chemical reaction. You have to first of all know who is the one who is asking this question and is restless. You are the conscious mind. You are the thinking self. You are the incomplete I. That's how you have conceptualized yourself to be. You are the incomplete I, chasing association with tendencies in a hope that such an association would give you fullness. Of course, the hope keeps getting belied time and again. It's another matter that we never learn. Had your restlessness been a chemical reaction, then it could have been doused and mitigated or totally pacified using another chemical or some other reaction. How do you neutralize a chemical? Using another chemical. And there are so many who ask the same question and come up with a false answer. So they start thinking that their restlessness is also chemical. Chemical means material. So what do they do about their restlessness? They start feeding it chemicals and materials. You can either feed it a giant mansion or you can feed it marijuana. Both are chemicals, are they not? Both are materials. There is somebody who tries to assuage his restlessness through a mansion. And there is somebody who tries to placate his restlessness through marijuana. Are the two any different? What are the two having in common? Both think that restlessness is chemical and therefore has chemical solutions. Because any chemical would always have a chemical solution, right? What would ever, I ask you, neutralize a chemical? Some other chemical, what else? A chemical or a chemical process. So we believe in this philosophy. We are bad philosophers. We think our restlessness is material and is therefore for the sake of something material. And then we chase the material, often get it, and then stand disappointed once again. Getting it? He's saying, if my restlessness is not a chemical reaction, then why do I get affected by a situation? Knowing fully well that it is just a chemical reaction. No, that which you call as knowing is a chemical reaction. Therefore, it doesn't help. Real knowing is not a chemical reaction. It is a cessation of chemistry. But what we call as knowing or realizing or understanding is most definitely a chemical reaction. Get the difference, please. When I say, I understood. Oh, I know. Right, I see. What is happening? A lot of things are happening in the brain. It's a brain-related phenomena. Some part of the brain is getting activated. Electrical currents are flowing through new circuits. Some cells are beginning to receive more energy than others. New chemicals are getting formed. All that happens when I say, I have understood. Because when I say, I have understood, what I mean is, I have concluded. I am now able to put something in memory. And all that is nothing but activity related to hardwiring. The hardware is undergoing changes when you say, I have understood, or I know, or I realize, or I see. It is a chemical reaction. Because it is a chemical reaction, therefore, it is able to influence only the dimension of chemistry. You are not in that dimension, therefore it is not able to help you. Chemical would affect chemical. And you are not chemical, unfortunately. So anything that is chemical is not going to help you. That which you call as your personal knowledge or realization or understanding is also chemical. Therefore, it is not going to help you. Hence, those who have really known have not talked of this personal knowledge or knowing or whatever. They have talked of something else. Something else that is inconceivable by the brain. Something else that the brain has no interest in. Something else that the brain cannot get and not even oppose. Something else that comes when you start depending a little less on your brain. Something else that comes when, first of all, you have exhausted the fullest possibility of the brain. Spirituality is not an endeavor for the brainless. Spirituality is for the one who has gone till the last limit of the brain, explored it, tested it, and gained the fullest that could be from mental activity. And having gained the fullest that could be from mental activity, realized that there is only so much that the brain and the mind are capable of. And then you say, well, now, the beyond. Now, the beyond. No point, therefore, just tagging your inner tendencies or reactions or intuitions as chemistry. Because when you are tagging your inner movements as chemistry, the tagging itself is part of the chemistry. Therefore, the tagging does not help you in any way. You can have a machine that senses machines. That does not mean that the machine that senses machines is human or conscious. Right? Similarly, you can have knowledge that all our inner movements are just chemical. But that knowledge will not redeem you from the grip of chemistry. Even that knowledge is in the province of chemistry. Even the knowledge is chemical. So, you remain where you are, pretty much. Realization is very, very subtle. My favorite is, if you know that you have realized, then you haven't. If you know that you know, then you don't. If you know that you are, then you aren't. Right now, here, if you know that you are listening, then you aren't. Only the ones who do not even know that they are listening are actually listening. The listening of others will be impeded by their knowledge of listening. Getting it?